Everybody, it's Jolynn and Abby. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to our home here in Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm finally back from Egypt and finally reunited with Abby. It's been about 3 weeks since I've last seen her, and it's nice to be back home and being able to have her in my everyday routine. She's hanging out here on the couch, and I wanted to go ahead and start off with my first video back from my amazing
Finally
trip.
back from Egypt, and it's been a couple of days now. I'm not jet lagged, thank goodness. I am definitely ready to go ahead and pump out more daily videos for the channel, and I'm really excited to see my plant life unfurl for 2019. So, without further ado, I wanted to go ahead and talk about all of the things that I got today and yesterday that are very affordable pieces that I want to go ahead and add to my plant collection in Santa Monica. And I talk about this a lot on my channel that plant life in Las Vegas isn't as amazing as California. Majority of my plant collection comes from California. So today's haul, I'm really excited to take back to Santa Monica because I don't know what's going to fill them and where I'm going to style the particular items that I In the
got.
tail
So
end of Egypt, I got really sick, so
I think I'm all right now. I think it was like the pollution and the smoke, and it was just really bad there with the air. So I think I got sick either from the pollution and the smoke in Egypt or snorkeling in the Red Sea. I'm trying to get over this cold. All of the things that I got in today's haul that I'm going to be sharing with you guys are repurchased items. The items I found last season, I repurchased this season.
So the
So
first thing I want to talk about are these affordable plant stands. I have two of them already in my patio, and I got them on sale last year, and I was lucky enough to stumble upon them again. And these are Tiffany Blue metal plant stands. So I have, I think, both of my rickrack cactus and Bob Marley on them. I wanted to get more so I can get more focal piece type plants lifted up from the ground, and I can have them styled in my patio a different way. So I have two of the same things here. So I have two of them. I love them so much. I got two more. So I'm not exactly sure if the pattern on the top is the same as the one I already got last year, but I have two of the same size, and these are inexpensive. They were under $8 a
and
piece.
I also got the medium size plant stand, and this was under $11. So I'll show you the size difference here. So this is what they look like side by side. This one is a little bit bigger. There was a larger size for under $14, but I didn't think I needed it. I love this particular size, the medium size, and I think I already have this one. I'm not sure. I can't wait to go home and kind of compare them to my original set. But I'm excited to restyle my patio, see if I can get a little different look now that I have these three extra plant stands. And I love a good white planter on this Tiffany Blue plant stand. So stay tuned. I will go ahead and bring this back to my space in Santa Monica. And I love that they're so affordable and they're my favorite color. So love that. Being from Hawaii, and if you are from Hawaii, everybody shops at Walmart, and Walmart is everywhere. It's just like that here in Las Vegas. Walmart is everywhere and everyone shops at Walmart. But in California and Los Angeles, Santa Monica in particular, where I live, there's no Walmart. So I do not go to Walmart in California. So anytime I'm out here in Vegas, I like to stop into Walmart once in a while to see what's going on in their garden section. So I had to stop there and get something to fix up one of my belly dance costumes that I got in Egypt. And the white planters that I picked up last year are back in stock. So I picked up three in each print. Now, the ones that I got last year were bigger than these, and I remember I had to drill holes in them. These ones already come with a hole. So I'm really excited that I don't have to drill these planters. So I believe these are the same print, but just smaller than my original one. So that's really cool because they're very inexpensive and affordable, and I can just go ahead and fill them probably very easily. I got three in this print, and I got three in this print, and I can't wait to bring these back into my collection, and I'm pretty sure somebody can go ahead and fill them right away. I do have a lot of plants just sitting in my collection, waiting for the right aesthetic plant and planter. I'm very
patient when it comes to finding the right fit for a plant and planter. So I'm sure I can probably do a few shifts or with new plants coming into my collection for 2019. I know for a good minute, my potting bench was really stocked with white planters. And I know whenever I brought a plant home, I was probably going to be able to get it into a new home right away. And then towards the end of the year, I was scrambling for planters with the new plants that came into my collection. So I always like to be prepared, because knowing me, I get plants every week in my collection, and I love having white planters readily available. So these are going to be the first batch of white planters for 2019. I love them, and I love the fact that I don't have to drill any holes in these ones. And I know Kira picked up a bunch too. I seen her yesterday, and she also has this particular planters in her collection. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I am going to go back to California in 2 days, and I am excited to film content. I'm excited to get all of these items back into my space. Let me know down in the comments below, what do you think about the new purchases that I got for my plant collection in Santa Monica? I'm always on the lookout for affordable things that match my aesthetic. And I am definitely a huge fan of these. They are repurchased. I loved them so much last year that I didn't even think twice when I seen them again. I had to repurchase them. And with my space being pretty big when it comes to my patio, I know I'll have no problem finding space for these guys. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm really excited to go ahead and style these into my plant collection in Santa Monica. They're very affordable. Love them so much last year, I had to repurchase more this year. And that happens from time to time where I find the same products again the following season and I end up repurchasing them again. Like my Daiso Japan white planters, that happened to me already now 2 seasons in, and I love repurchasing them because they're just like the perfect size and the perfect price. So let me know down in the comments below, where do you shop for affordable things for your plant collection? So let me know down in the comments below, what did you think about the items that I repurchased? I would love to know in the comments, where do you go to find affordable plant life items? I'm definitely a huge fan of TJ Maxx, Marshalls, Home Goods, and Walmart for Las Vegas. Those are like my go-to places, because if you go to a garden center or anything like that, these planters can get really expensive. Again, if I could have all white planters in my collection, I would, but my collection is so big and I like spending at least under $15 for each planter, because I have such a huge collection. So terracottas is like my go-to if I can't find a white affordable planter. So excited to plant these up. So stay tuned for a pot of fame, because a whole month passed by and I'm actually excited to see who grew on me while I was away. So I'm looking forward to going back to my plant collection, and I'm looking forward to my new schedule. So there is a major shift in my Los Angeles schedule, which is better for me and all around for the channel and myself and for Ebby. And thank you guys so much for supporting my channel. After some time thinking and getting away from Los Angeles and Las Vegas, I made a decision to leave one of my jobs, so I will no longer have to wake up at 4:30 in the morning. And I know I say that a lot on my channel, that I get up at 4:30 in the morning for work in Los Angeles, but I made a decision over my time away in Egypt that I wanted a better schedule for myself. So I do still work every day, but I won't be at one of my jobs in Los Angeles. I'll be at my other job in Los Angeles more. I'll be able to sleep in a little longer, and I'll be able to focus more on my channel without having to stay up till midnight to edit, because juggling like my teaching schedule and my dance schedule out here and doing YouTube every day, it's definitely taking up all of the hours in the day, and I'm not able to do anything. So hopefully with my new Los Angeles schedule, with one less job out there, I'll be able to still do YouTube every day and at least be able to do things for myself besides work, work, and work. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and this little update on where my life is at right now. I'm excited to go back to Los Angeles. I'm excited to do so many things for the channel, and I hope you guys enjoyed the little Egypt content I was able to get for the main channel. But stay tuned, because I will be uploading to my vlog channel my Egypt travels, which I'm really excited to share with on the channel. If you guys enjoyed this video and this update, let me know down in the comments below. You can find more on my blog at ilovejulian.blogspot.com. I miss you guys so much, and I'll see you guys soon. Until next time, aloha from the Ninth Island, Las Vegas, Nevada. Bye guys.